take a journey through the principles of architectural design and their relationships with each other. From balance to rhythm, every principle forms part of the design that shapes the built environment we live in today. Hello there. Welcome to our architectural journey. Today we are going on a journey on the basic design principles of architecture. Architectural design principles are the building blocks of successful design. While they each focus on different elements of the design, they must work in tandem to ensure that a structure is visually aesthetic. First of all, let's talk about balance as the basic principle of architectural design. Balance in architecture refers to the equal or proportionate distribution and arrangement of elements such as shape, form, color, texture, details, etc. This principle aims to create a sense of stability and equilibrium in the architectural design. Application of balance in architectural designs helps in enhancing the visual aesthetics of the structure, making it more appealing and functional. In essence, it assures that no area of the design overpowers the other, and harmony is maintained throughout. There are two main types of balance, symmetrical and asymmetrical. First, symmetrical balance is achieved when similar or identical elements are placed around a central axis or point. It's common in traditional and historic buildings. Second, asymmetrical balance is achieved through the use of different elements that have equal visual weight or eye attraction. The design doesn't need to be mirrored on each side, but still provides balance. Contrast, as an architectural principle, refers to the idea of juxtaposing different elements or aspects of design to highlight their differences and create element of focus. This can be achieved through the use of different colors, shapes, textures, sizes, or architectural styles. Contrast can be used to highlight certain elements or areas in a design, making them stand out and drawing attention to them. It can help to create a focal point or to differentiate between different parts of a building or space. For example, a modern building may be constructed alongside a traditional one to highlight the differences between the past and the present. Similarly, a sleek, minimalist design may be contrasted with a detailed, ornate one to create visual interest. Contrast can also be used to create harmony and balance within a design. While contrasting elements can stand out, they can also work together to create a balanced and cohesive whole. However, it's important to use contrast carefully and thoughtfully. Too much contrast can become overwhelming and create visual clutter, while too little can result in a bland and uninteresting design. Proportion is an important principle in architecture, because it helps create a sense of unity and cohesiveness in a design. This principle ensures that there is a harmonious scale between all individual elements of the structure, keeping everything in a ratio that is pleasing to the eye. For example, the height of a building should be in proportion with its width and depth, so that it doesn't look too tall, too wide, or too thin. Similarly, the size of windows or doors should be in proportion with the entire facade. Historically, many cultures have developed standards of proportion for architectural design. For example, the ancient Greeks developed the golden ratio, a mathematical ratio that they believed created pleasing, harmonious proportions. In addition to the golden ratio, there are also other proportioning systems that architects may use in their designs, such as the modular system developed by Le Corbusier or the Vitruvian system developed by Vitruvius. These systems provide a set of guidelines for achieving balance and harmony in a design. In addition to aesthetic reasons, proportion is also crucial for the structural integrity of a building. Designing a building with properly proportioned elements ensures that the weight and forces are evenly distributed, providing stability and durability. Hierarchy in architectural principles refers to the way elements are ordered in terms of significance. For instance, in a building's design, certain areas may be emphasized to show they are of greater importance than other spaces. The larger, more grandiose elements such as tall towers or grand entrances are often seen as the most important, while smaller, less noticeable details are considered to be of lower importance. This also relates to the use and function of a space. For instance, in a home, the living area and kitchen may be given more attention in design as they are frequently used, compared to a quiet study room. It also plays a role in the flow and movement within a space. It can guide where people should go, indicating pathways and emphasizing focal points. Hierarchy helps to organize space, create balance and harmony, guide users of the space, and reflect the purpose or function of a building or design. Rhythm as an architectural principle ties in closely with the concepts of repetition and pattern. It involves the placement of architectural design elements in manner that creates a flow or sense of movement. In the field of architecture, rhythm can be achieved in a variety of ways. It can be as straightforward as a repetition of identical elements such as windows or columns in evenly spaced intervals. It can also be created through a progression of shapes or colors, where each element is similar but not identical to the last. Achieving rhythm in architectural design can provide a cohesive, harmonious aesthetic, guiding the viewer's attention throughout the space in an organized, predictable manner. This principle of design is often used to bring balance, unity, and emphasis to architectural features. Just as in music or poetry, rhythm in architecture can create a sense of anticipation and predictability. This can contribute to the sense of comfort and familiarity in a space, making it more welcoming and inviting to its occupants. However, it's important to strike a balance, as overly repetitious spaces can feel monotonous and dull, while insufficient rhythm can lead to a sense of chaos or disorganization. In architecture, unity refers to the harmony and coherence among various parts or elements of a building or structure that creates a sense of completeness. Unity can be achieved through proportions, symmetry, repetition, and alignment. The elements used and their arrangement work together, leading to a balanced and aesthetically pleasing structure. Unity involves tying all aspects of a design together to ensure they function as one while complementing each other. For instance, the structure, floor plan, materials, design styles, colors, and even landscaping should all work together to create an aesthetically pleasing, functional, and consistent design. Unity is necessary in architecture because it helps to maintain a balance and consistency, which are vital in creating visually attractive buildings and structures. It also creates a sense of order and ensures that the building or design doesn't appear chaotic or disjointed. Variety in architecture is a principle that promotes diversity and uniqueness in design. It is the inclusion and use of different elements, shapes, colors, textures, materials, or themes in a design to make it more interesting, attractive, and to avoid monotony or repetition. This principle can be implemented in several ways: the architecture's form, space arrangement, scale, architectural style, or use of materials. For instance, an architect may use a variety of materials such as stone, brick, glass, and metal to create an interesting look and feel. Architects can leverage variety to meet diverse user needs effectively. For instance, in residential buildings, each floor or unit might feature a distinct design. This principle serves not only aesthetic purposes, but also enhances the functionality of the design. However, while using the principle of variety, it's crucial to maintain a balance to prevent chaos or confusion. Using too much variety can create visual discord and a lack of overall cohesion. It's essential to combine variety with other architectural principles like balance, unity, and harmony to create a well-rounded design. Emphasis in terms of design is a point of focus in the composition. It determines the visual weight of the design, establishes space and perspective, and often resolves where the eye goes first when looking at the design. Every design should have a single primary visual element called a focal point. It is given to an area within the design because the area is meant to be seen or is more important when compared to the other elements of design. For example, rose windows or recessed doorways from Gothic architecture, windscoops, fireplaces, staircases, balconies, and many more. Emphasis can be achieved by increased size, strong color, greater detail, sharp contrast, distorted shape, contrasting size, placement and positioning, movement of the image. For instance, a large fireplace at the end of a long room would naturally draw the eye and become a focal point. A grand, towering entrance would create emphasis in a building's design. A bright red door on an otherwise muted building would stand out and draw the eye. Movement in architecture is a design principle that focuses on the effects of motion or the illusion of motion in a building or structure. It refers to how people move through, interact with, and experience a space. The intention behind using movement as a principle is to create an engaging and dynamic experience for people who use the space. It can also dictate how a building is perceived, both from the inside and outside, by giving it a sense of life and activity. Buildings can be designed with forms and shapes that suggest movement, such as curving walls, sloping roofs, or asymmetric designs. Stairways, elevators, corridors, or common rooms are designed to manage and choreograph the movement of people. Certain patterns or colors can subtly direct people where to go, or make a building seem dynamic even if it's static. Also, innovative use of technology can physically change a building's shape, structure, and appearance to respond to its environment or user needs.